Hello and welcome to this review of the Sirui 50mm f1.8 anamorphic lens for micro four thirds. Before I show you what you can do with this lens, I'll quickly talk about the build quality. The lens is all metal and is solidly built. It comes vacuum packed and you can see that in my unboxing short. It's longer than most micro four third lenses and it's really heavy, and I found this made it fiddly to use when using it on a camera mounted to a gimbal. At the front of the lens there's a 67mm filter thread, and the front element doesn't rotate when focusing, which is really useful when using filters. The lens cap is also really good and a good fit too. Closest focus is 85cm and the lens has focus markings from 85cm up to 15m and then infinity. The aperture goes from f1.8 to f16. The thing you're most interested in is, how does the lens look? What is the footage like? I went out and I did some test shooting on a Panasonic G7 in 4K and the Olympus EM10 Mark II in 1080p. Both were filmed at 24 frames per second at f1.8 with a shutter speed of 1/50th of a second. I mounted the Panasonic on a gimbal, but for the Olympus I just used the built-in image stabilization. The day of filming was incredibly sunny, so an ND was crucial to avoid overexposure while keeping to the 180 degree shutter rule. I think the image is really good. It has really good contrast and it has a really good organic character. This isn't a lens that you'd vlog with. Focus is fully manual, it's heavy, and it has a very large minimum focusing distance, so it's not good for vlogging. But it does give superb image quality in video. And really, it's made to give very good quality video. With bright lights, the image is going to give a blue flare, and you can see those flares here at night time. I paid £425 for this lens, and it's a great way to get into anamorphic video on a budget. While I would have preferred a wider focal length, those lenses were out of my budget range. The only downside is that the length and weight of the lens pushed my gimbal to the limits of what's possible, and you can see quite a bit of jitter in the Panasonic footage. Perhaps this is due to my technique rather than the gimbal. Overall, this is an excellent lens and I really like it. Thank you. Goodbye.